I knew the houses were bad in this game, but I didn't know they were this bad. Someone got paid to build this. Can I get that job? I'd love to get paid real cash money for this kind of effort. A couple videos back, we looked at some memes about EA builds. The fact that they routinely leave out doors, toilets, and make the most embarrassingly empty and downright ugly builds, it got me thinking, when was the last time I looked at or even played in a base game build? So, to kick off my in-depth, ultimate review series of The Sims 4 base game, we are taking a look back at what EA deemed acceptable housing and laughing mercilessly at them. Let's take a trip to the low-rent area of Willow Creek to Garden Essence and see what wonders this house holds. You walk through the door and bam, there's a table. I know this is nitpick level, but of all the places you could put that table and not obstruct traffic, you chose there. That is a dining table, not a coffee table. I know this house is supposed to be cheap, but there is cheap furniture and then there is stupid. Trash can in the middle of the floor, no light in the kitchen, missing window. The real mystery of this house is where Travis got this picture. $1,400 picture on the wall, and you are sleeping in the worst bed in the game. The continuity in this house is a mess. Finally, an answer to why most of the big furniture sticks out a good foot from the wall. Surprise, it's coded wonky. No wonder so many people think the base game furniture is trash. Next up on our tour of sad base game houses is Daisy Hovel, and she's cute on the outside. Inside, not so much. Can someone explain this kitchen to me? You had all this empty space, and this is what you came up with? This kitchen needs a few less walls and a few more brain cells expended on the layout. Oh boy, Streamlit Single is just as empty, but has some randomly placed furniture. Not everything has to be placed on the diagonal. Can you even see the TV from that distance? And the separate kitchen room is just more space this house didn't need. Crick Cabana, my favorite. Well, not this version. My updated version that is a comfy home for four is my favorite. Wow. I don't know if I've ever seen a home that is simultaneously overbuilt and also extremely cramped. Does that chair in the back actually work? Parents' room with no door. I sense a lot of traumatized children in this house's future. We are moving on to more expensive houses. Does more money mean better decorated houses? I guess we'll find out. Oh, Rindle Rose, channeling its inner vampira and not doing a very good job at it. Make the house look interesting, but also like the person who built it had no idea what they were doing. Oh yay, our friend's trash can in the middle of the floor and furniture in front of the door have returned but somehow have become worse. Also, not a fan of how small this kitchen is. This just screams traffic jam to me. On to Peak Hearth, and this dining room isn't half bad. The kitchen is another story. Got another trash can just chilling in the way and a cupboard that doesn't match up with the counter. Okay, who sets up their couches like this? You want to walk all the way around to watch TV? Real talk, do people actually angle their furniture at 45 degree angles like this? The end table around the corner is an interesting decision. Weird question, but can Bob even get into bed on that side? Riverside Roost with two front doors. Yes, I know there is such a thing as a double shotgun house. However, a double shotgun house implies that there are two families living there. In The Sims, though, you just wonder why the house has two doors. Does anyone else see an alligator when they look at this house? Red bookcase, yellow and green chairs, and a pink sofa all in the same room. Daring. I thought I saw some bad kitchens, but wow. Tell me you gave up without telling me you gave up. Oh, Brook Bungalow, why must you have small windows surrounded by giant ones? How many arches do you really need? At this point, why do you even have a wall? This living room bothers me and I can't put my finger on why. It could be the six lamps, the fact that if anyone wants to sit down, they have to walk in front of the TV, or it could be because this layout is absolute bonkers. Take your pick. Ooh, different kitchen, same layout problem. Are we seeing a theme yet? This obsession with double wide doors and arches really screws you over in the design department. I get a lot of satisfaction thinking about how this probably caused immense headaches for everyone involved. Okay, I'm going to need you to pick a color. We have blue, we have yellow, we have green, and we have orange. Pick two, preferably not the green and orange. All right, we're moving into the really expensive houses now. And we start with the ugly queen of expensive houses, Ophelia Villa, home to the goths. Again, what is the point of the wall if you plaster it with arches? Just add one more and every goth can have their own arch. Why is there this tacky chair sitting in the kitchen away from the table? Is Alexander not allowed to join his family at the kitchen table? And where is Cassandra gonna sit? At the big dining table where everyone else sits and calls into question the very existence of this table. How many counters do you want? All of them, apparently. And whoever was trying to be fancy with this dividing line between rooms, just don't. Top of the stairs and we have an absolutely massive room with zero function. Did it need to be this big? No. Did you need to make more furniture so that these houses wouldn't look like half the furniture has been stolen? Yes. Do we believe for 1 second that Cassandra would have something as tacky as this poster in her room? That Bella and Mortimer would allow her to tack something like this up on her wall? And poor Alexander with the furniture leftovers. It really does look like the developers added him and his room at the last second. Next door to the Goths is Park Shore, and it is more of the same. Empty expanses and weird furniture placement. I just love the lonely chicken picture. So festive. Wow, another pointless room with a lost trash can. Kitchen and dining room are decent. It's a travesty that we don't have spare chairs chilling like we do in practically every other expensive house. Upstairs, we have yet another corner nightstand, but this one manages to be even more awkward than the one in the pancake house. Yet another blue children's room. Do you know any other colors? You know what? These duplicate pictures are really beginning to grow on me. Yes, I'd like to buy several copies of the same picture and place them all on top of each other. At least get creative with their placement. Onto Umbridge Manor, and already I can tell we're going to have some interesting shaped rooms. Why would anyone have two islands in their living room? And then not even making it symmetrical. You can really see them scraping the bottom of the creativity barrel with so little furniture. I swear, whoever builds these houses loves blue. If you don't love blue as much as them, you are completely out of luck. Oakinstead, finally a normal looking house. A shame it is slightly hampered by the developers not knowing how to match colors. Yes, we want a dining room that can double as a ballroom for all those non-existent parties we throw. And our kitchen should be able to handle at least everyone in Willow Creek. If you're going to have rooms this size, I think you need more lamps. I wonder if this room would look better with the bed in pink. Nope, still looks like garbage just with 50 shades of pink. Oh, Cypress Terrace, so many memories of you. Like having a Sim start cooking in the kitchen and then walk up two flights of stairs to cook in the bathroom. Good times. This table being off-center is slightly annoying, and I'm not a big fan of windows inside the house. What practical purpose do these have? Never has so much space been taken up by so little. If you have to fill space with huge impractical things, maybe make the room smaller? Okay, this bedroom is confusing. First off, it looks like half a Quonset hut is attached to this house. Second, it looks like someone wanted to make this two separate rooms and just gave up. Moving upstairs, and could we please pick a color? Green, purple, pink, red. The baffling part is all this furniture comes in multiple colors. Surely you could find colors in the same family. Bathroom has a very obvious and very weird counter problem. Good to know that if I went to get fancy with the counters, I shouldn't bother because the developers sure didn't. Not only cheap sinks, but cheap blue sinks in this nice modern bathroom. Good try making it work with the blue mirrors, but there is a reason people don't model their bathrooms after public restrooms. It looks really tacky. Let's move on to the venues rapid fire style because there isn't much to say about their mediocreness. Magnolia Blossom is fine. I've just never seen a building modeled after a sippy cup before. Willow Creek Archives, pretty boring and plain. I never visit here and didn't know that there's an upstairs. This chair in the middle of the floor is a bit weird though. Movers and Shakers Gym. It's a functional gym. Do not ask me what is going on with the bathroom, but when the walls render properly, it's an easy place to get your Sims mortified. I know I said get creative with placement. This is a little too much. On to the Blue Velvet Nightclub. Fond memories of coming here on a date, sitting right next to the fire, and trying to be romantic with six other Sims in my conversation. And then trying to get a drink from the bar, and there are 10 Sims all crowded around it, glitching out the bartender. This place has a second floor? A very useless second floor. And the Municipal Muses Museum. Does anyone actually visit this place? Sad and pathetic does not do this place justice. Now that we had our fun in Willow Creek, it is time to turn our attention to Oasis Springs. Raffia Quinta, interesting roof. Tiny kitchen is tiny. What is this obsession with having lights putting out red light? On to Vista Quarry. Why is this trash can literally miles from the kitchen? Really? Another cramped kitchen and another oversized bathroom? It's like you want traffic jams at every meal. Remember when I said not to mix green and orange? This is why. Nothing good comes from mixing burnt sienna and sewage green. Springscape with the mint green front door and the orange windows in the back. I feel like I need a bad trash can counter at this point. Love the empty end table in the corner. Another asymmetrical monstrosity around the TV. As someone who loves green green? Even eye scalding neon green? This is too much green. Another weird roof on Cacti Casa. Okay, this trash can isn't too bad, just move it back half a space. I thought the living room with a green couch and an orange couch plus a blue lamp was weird, but this takes the cake. What color do you want to make this room? All of the ugly ones. Nookstone, who did this to you? Two-tone houses can look good, but this does not. Wow, we're back to big empty houses and diagonal furniture. This house isn't too bad, but you can remove 30% of it and still have plenty of room. Sand trap flat is form over function. Yes, I'd like to stand on my porch and still get rained on. Oh wow, this house is just dark. This kitchen is interesting, totally functional, but just strange. Oh, agave abode with your weird green trim. Let's see what horrors lie within. Dreary kids room, check. Odd wall placements, check. Tiny kitchen, wait, where's the TV? You have a couch staring at nothing. How about you delete these stupid walls, make some of these rooms smaller, and buy the poor Sims who have to live in this abomination a freaking TV? Oh yay, slipshod mesquite. Can't wait to see what is inside. Trash can in the hallway. Mint green and red kitchen. Interesting choice. Red sofa, red chair, green curtains. Are we going for a Christmas motif here? Moving on to the more expensive homes. Granada Place. My, you have a pretty overlook. Too bad your balcony is looking at your neighbor's house. Wow, the Christmas motif continues. I think they are trying to be Southwestern here, but you don't see a lot of red and green in Southwestern decor. Finally, a reasonably sized kitchen, although I'm not really sure what is going on with that island. Another orange and green room. Why? Were we clamoring for another one? Now this room is a bit better in terms of color, although why is there an orange chair? It looks pretty out of place when everything else is color coordinated to the rug. The Caliente house, sultry Springside, is next, and something about that tiny off-center window bothers me. Why is there a giraffe in the dining room? There is a set of drapes on that wall, but no window.
Run.
Just a general tip, not everything has to be blindingly yellow. And just because something comes in yellow doesn't mean it needs to be in yellow. Just changing the bedding to red makes this room look 100 times better. Rio Verde, or the house that single-handedly keeps the arch-making companies in business. Do I need to say anything about this island? Yet another blue bedroom. Whoopee. This bedroom, if you make some color tweaks, it's downright cute. Now, I question the thought process behind this room. Every single night, a Sim is going to have to traverse around all this furniture just to get to bed. Yuma Heights, the massive three-story monolith. Just look at this. How can we make this massive room look less empty? Plants, the same plant 6 times under every single window. Instead of spreading out all these pictures on all these empty walls, let's just stick them all together in a clump. With all this empty space, what could you possibly need the third floor for? Oh, another massive bedroom because this house didn't have enough of that. Affluista Mansion, another monster-sized house. Okay, this is not what I was expecting. How plain. No weird-shaped island? What's going on? Finally, the super weird form over function stuff I've become accustomed to. And the TV isn't even lined up with the couch. Just when I thought this house was going to be boring gray and beige, then you find this room. I found where the color budget went. And then we are back to boring Blandville. I'm a bit disappointed with this house. You look at the kooky exterior and wonder what strange design decisions are on the inside, and then it's just this. Let's talk about the Oasis Springs venues. First off is Desert Bloom, and it's fine. Not really sure how that roof is going to keep out the rain. This room is awfully cramped. Stereo for dancing, bar for juice, a lot of stuff in here, and very little room to maneuver. Rattlesnake Juice Bar. The best thing about you is that you have a TV. That way I can ignore your ugly decor and zone out to the Weather Channel. Such a level of care with this lot that the condiments aren't centered on half of these tables. Burners and Builders, another gray blob of a building on this road. Okay, without a juice bar or vending machines, who is using this oddly shaped island? More bathrooms that will make your Sims mortified to use. Another case of builders not knowing how the game works and just building whatever. Onto the Solar Flare, and honestly, this is it. There are a lot of couches just everywhere and chairs just chilling. Come and listen to someone make terrible jokes, drink overpriced drinks, and hear someone play the piano badly. Oh joy. Another museum. The Future's Past Museum is past its prime and should be put out of its misery. Why is there a trash can here by the front door? Wouldn't it make much more sense to put it back by the juice bar? And there's a juice bar, but there's nowhere to sit. Psst, what about the hidden secret lots? What about them? Just more empty nothingness. If you can manage to cheat or mod them so you can live on them or camp on them, they might be fun, but otherwise they are pretty set dressing. Final thoughts, 7 years later and they still expect $40 for this crap. This level of design is embarrassing for free, but this is EA. Put as little effort in and reap massive rewards.